Hey, this is Mike. I'm down here at Judd Kuhn Chevrolet in North Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, and they have a 2015 Chevy Colorado, and I really wanted to look at one of these, and I called Lee, and he said they had one in, so here it is. This is the 2015 Chevy Colorado. It has a four-cylinder and a six-speed transmission, and I'm impressed. I kind of looked it over, and it's a pretty good, well-planned out truck, and it has a good size too. It's not like a big monster truck, and it's not like a little itty-bitty thing either. It's kind of like a really good size vehicle, at least for me anyway. Your preferences might be different. So here in the front, we've got some projector headlights and fog lights. I'll have to check on the window sticker and see if they're halogen or what they are. Alloy wheels. Now, they're 17-inch wheels, by the way. Just look at the overall stance of this truck and the way it's shaped. And when I pulled up and looked at it, I looked at the pictures, but basically when you see it in person, it just has a... It's pleasing to my eyes anyway. I don't know about you, but I really like it. So here's the key fob here, and basically it has to be locked, and I'm going to go ahead and start it up because this one has a remote start. You push the lock button, then you hold down the start button there. So now that it's started, I can unlock the doors. Take a look on this side here. So here's the inside of the door, the passenger door. You can see it has a little pocket right here. Little tiny separate one here. I'm not sure why they separate that. Maybe there's a reason. And then you've got a bottle holder there, and then down here is another little tiny pocket. This one kind of looks like a cell phone holder. It's about the size of an average cell phone. Unless you got like a phablet or something, then you can put it down here, I guess. And this is hard plastic. This is hard plastic. This is kind of soft here. Soft, very soft there. This is kind of hard. Now the seats are a combination of power and the back of the seat is controlled here, so it's a combination of power and manual adjustments. And it is a gray leather interior, and it's kind of like a gray and a black mixed. There's a glove compartment, which is pretty good size, really good size. And then this door, this is a four-door truck, but this one opens up the suicide way, is what they used to call it. And it's a little door here, makes it easier to access the inside, so that way you don't have any center bar. It's completely opens up, and you can access the whole vehicle right here. But here's the inside of the back door, and as you can see from the seats, they are made for a smaller person or a child. I don't think I can. I probably could fit back there for a short trip or something, but I don't see me driving back there for a long period of time. But here's the door here. You got a bottle holder, and you got a handle and a speaker, and so it's pretty minimal. But you do have a window, so you can see in and out, so you don't get too claustrophobic. Of course, you've got the window there. So let's see what's back here. Little tiny seat. It does have a headrest. It does have the latch system, these little connections here for a child seat, child safety seat. And then this here looks like, yeah, that looks like a cable for the anchor for the child seat. And they are leather seats as well. So I bet you I need two hands to lift it up. Let's see, I'll pull this. Lift it up. Okay. So now it lifts up and locks in place. That little strap is how I did it. And there's like a storage space underneath the seat here, and which is pretty interesting. I'm not sure. This looks like the headrest can go here. I'm not really sure what that. Sure does look like the headrest can go there. I'm not sure. Maybe you know. If you can let me know, I'd appreciate it. But anyway, it looks like got some storage underneath the seat here, and this flops back down. And then you've got some cup holders, and all kids have portable devices now, so they good job in putting some USB ports for charging back here, as well as a regular charger, and in a little pocket right here. And I'm trying out a new camera today, so let me know if you can tell a difference. I don't know if this is going to be my new camera or what for my videos, but just kind of tell me, you know, how it looks. Audio too, very important, audio and video. Alright, so there's the rear view mirror. We've got some chrome on the back of it. You can see my new camera. And I don't have my normal fig rig with me, so I forgot it. So I use this, basically a monopod, as a little bit of a, give it some little bit of stabilization there. Alright, so let's move back here. You can see the truck has a little bit of a slant to it. It kind of gives that traditional pickup stance. This is the LT trim, and I'll copy and paste the whole window sticker in the description so you can kind of look through all the options if you're interested. Alright, so looking back here, I see something really cool, and that is these steps right here on the corner. So basically, so you can step up there, it's on both sides, it's designed to where you can lower the tailgate, which slowly drops on its own. I don't know if you caught that, but I'm going to let go. I'm going to lift it up, and then I'm going to let go of it. You see it slowly lowers, so that way it don't come slamming down. So once it's down, basically, you can put your foot here and climb up in the truck. A lot easier than just trying to make that first jump there on the back of the tailgate. And this has some height to it, so it's not it's not a little itty-bitty truck. But it's not a monster either. This one has a plastic bed liner that the dealer has added, but you can get it with without a plastic bed liner. You can, you know, spray in bed liner or whatever you want. So back here, well hidden, is the backup camera. Some people call it the reverse camera, and we'll take a look at that while we're in the truck. It is a locking tailgate, which is very good. And I'm noticing it doesn't have LED lights. It has a regular light bulb there, but I wonder if it's because of the trim. Maybe. So let's take a look at the gas cap. And it does have a gas cap right there. And it looks like they've got another place here. And usually when they have two places like that, it's for a DEF fluid. So I wonder if they're going to have if they already have a diesel option in this truck. That'd be interesting. Alright, this side rear view mirror has a little separate adjustable for kind of help you with the blind spots. Alright, here's the inside of the driver's door. You got the same pockets basically as the other side. It's basically mirrored on this side. And so then you got your power windows. It's not going to work because the key's not on, but let me go ahead and put the key in. Still have to, even though it's running, you still have to turn the key on and turn everything on. So here's the power windows. Let's see if it's, yep, I just push it one time and it goes right down. And lift it up one time and it goes right up. So I don't have to sit there and hold my hand on there to roll up and down the windows. Side mirrors, you can adjust them right here. Pretty standard. Power locks. And this one, same thing. Part of the seat is electric. Some of it's, this is a lumbar support, by the way. But this is the where you make the seat tilt forward, the back of the seat there. There's your dimmer switch. It does have automatic headlights. And I like the way vehicles now have the floor mats, how they snap in place, because I really can't stand when floor mats slide around on you and they just really gets annoying. Alright, so let me hop in here, make a slight adjustment to the seat. and the seat's pretty comfortable. I got some good back support, and it feels like a firm seat. It's not too soft and like pillowy. All right, so here's the steering wheel, and it is this one has a leather wrap steering wheel with stitching on the inside. There's a Chevrolet logo, and your cruise control is on this side. Basically make sure that it's turned on, and there's a little indicator on the gauge there that turns on and off when you push that button. Just make sure it's on, and then you can set the cruise control. And then on this side, looks like you've got some voice recognition options and your volume control and change to the stations, and basically you can hang up a call right here too. And I like the way they got this little grip thing here going on, a little bit of thickness there, and it gives us kind of a sportier look, and I like it. There's the gauges. Now this one has the controls. You've got your tachometer here, your RPMs, and your regular speedometer on the right, and then you got gas gauge, temperature gauge, but there in the middle is a little screen there, and that is controlled with these buttons here. So like I said, I'm going to push menu, and I'm going to kind of go to vehicle, and then I'm going to scroll down with this little thing here and get some more information. Tire pressure, battery voltage, engine hours, transmission fluid temperature. You see you get a lot of information there. So I'm going to push menu again, and it's going to go into your fuel economy. And I can, basically you can, while you're driving, you can get a real-time estimate on what you're getting on your gas fuel mileage. Pushing trip again, pushing menu again over here takes me to the trip, and I can scroll down, and there's trip one, trip two, and then you've got a range. So average vehicle speed, timer, navigation, no active route. So then default basically is your speedometer there. So that's a neat little screen that has some good information, and right here where it says E, that is vehicles facing east, and the vehicle has 192 miles on it. Alright, see, there's your key, there's your windshield wiper controls on this side. Now here's your like a big screen here, and this is kind of like your vehicle computer, and right here it has all these icons, sort of like on a desktop on a computer. You have different icons that you can choose, and but this one's, you know, similar concept. Right here, 54 degrees, that's the outside temperature. It's a little bit cool out, and there's your clock. So I'm gonna go in the audio icon and kind of see what's here. So this one's got AM, let's see here, there's your presets on your AM. Exit there, go to browse, oh, the same thing. I'm gonna hit the back button down here. Let me see right here, see what this does. Tone setting. Oh, that's your audio control. Okay. All right. So I'm going to push menu, radio down here. Change to the stations, XM, FM, and FM. AM, FM, and XM. Getting tongue-tied. So it's got satellite radio and then the regular AM, FM radio. Satellite is free for a certain time. I don't remember what it is with the new vehicles on the Chevrolets, but you do get a free window of opportunity to listen to it. Alright, so I'm going to hit the home button and go back to your icons. Phone, this is where once you pair your phone, you'll have your contacts, your recent calls, you'll have a keypad to make calls, and you can use your voice, that voice button there, and this one right here, basically you can push the button and say call a certain person in your contacts, as long as you're saying it like what's in the contacts. Voicemail, I don't have any experience with that, so I'll have to refer to anybody in the comments that know. And then you can have multiple phones paired. Now, I wonder, I'm not seeing on here, and there could be a way of doing it. Is there a way to transfer it back to your cell phone once you're in a call? It might pop up once you're in a call. I'm not sure. All right, so let me hit the home button here. OnStar Nav, I guess, like, say you would have to select an active route, call OnStar. I'm not really sure. I don't want to call OnStar and, you know, activate anything here, so I'm kind of skip this section. Pandora, this is where you have play music through an internet radio station called Pandora, and I'm not sure if it connects to your cell phone, Pandora on your cell phone, or as it has its own individual connection. I'm not sure. Maybe you can tell me if you know. I'm pushing home. Text. Apparently you can text message through here. I guess it's probably voice recognition. You can say certain things and text people without actually taking your hands off the wheel and your eyes off the road, which is good. Because that's the way a lot of people keep up with each other, through texting. Alright, so there's the main highlights there. And let's see what we got here. Oh, those are your presets for your radio, I believe. There's a volume button here. Like I was using the home button, back button, the radio, and the media. Now the media, I'm going to push that button. Right now, I'm just going to hit devices. Basically, the media is where, like, you, once you pair your cell phone with the Bluetooth system, you can play music directly off the phone. You can also play music off this USB and auxiliary input down here. So that way it gives you other options to play music through the system. Alright, so down here we've got some climate control, and there it kind of shows on the screen what I'm doing, and so there's the fan speed there, and you can turn it on and off. Here's the temperature. I can set it to a certain number up there, and it's also right out there on the knob, and I like the way it has the bright blue and red there, so it kind of gives you a really clear indicator of what knob you need to touch to get the temperature down while you're driving. Down here is where you want the air to blow, front and rear defrosters, a recirculation button, and your air conditioning button. I'll turn that off. Got a traction control button here, and here's a cargo light button, which is pretty cool. You can turn that on and your cargo lights are on, and I don't really have the ability to show you during the day too much, but at nighttime, I'm curious to see what it looks like. Now this one's got heated seats, and you can heat the lower part of the seat or the back of the seat, and that's on both front seats here. Then you got a little pocket, kind of small pocket. It's not big enough to put a cell phone or anything in. It's kind of small. I'm not sure, maybe a few coins or something, but iPod, I'm not really sure what. If it was a little bit deeper, it would probably be a perfect place to put your cell phone. Alright, so in addition to the USB port and the auxiliary input, you also have this, this power supply here. It's a 12 volt power supply. Got some storage space there. And kind of do a zoom out here because I know I'm getting close in and it's disorienting sometimes. So right here, I'm down this way, and I'm moving my way towards the shifter. And the shifter is, you know, just kind of a regular shifter. It has a button on the back side here to change gears, and it has two buttons here on the side to shift through the gears. But I'm going to go ahead and just put it in reverse, just so we can see what this backup camera looks like. And it looks pretty good. It looks pretty good. It's not super clear. Now the lines there will move as I'm moving the steering wheel to give you an estimated trajectory of the truck as it's backing up. And basically you can see the tailgate, the bottom of the tailgate there, and the bumper, and this will go all the way up. It's a wide angle lens, sort of like a GoPro camera, so it gives you a really good view. Really handy for backing up the trailers, and also really handy to avoid running over stuff that happens to be lying on the ground. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and put it back in park. And then you've got your cup holders here, pocket there, and then this is a armrest that lifts up. And here you've got a big storage area, and a USB charger there, so that's pretty handy. And there's a place there for putting your wires in and out of this compartment in case you need to run wires in there. Very deep pocket, storage pocket. Alright, so let's go ahead and look underneath the hood. This is the four-cylinder engine here, and it does have a VVT system. And if you're not familiar with that, you should check out me and Matt's video, What is VVT? Ask the engineer student video series. It's a quiet engine. And it doesn't look like a little tiny four-cylinder. You can see in there pretty good. Sorry about the strap being in the way. All right, there you have it. If you have any questions, let me know. I'm going to leave Judd Kuhn's contact information here in the description, so that way you can contact them about any questions as far as pricing and stuff like that, or rebates and all that good stuff. So I appreciate you watching, and I'll see you next time.